Okay guys, from phase one, we have learned several types of evidence for argument essays. So for this phase, we're going to put it into practice. So let's look at this topic.
It's actually a real argumentative essay topic. Should university students grade their professors?
We know that at the end of the semester, usually we do this online course evaluation.
Yep.
And do you have the experience of this?
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's great. So you have some opinions about this. So do you think that it really helps professors to improve their teaching performance, or it's not that effective? So now I want you like think about for 1 minute to think aside whether you agree or disagree about this topic. It's just for your individual thinking. You gonna agree on that. Later we're gonna have discussion session.
So which kind of thing is you have this paper, it's actually the sample of
your forum, which I forgot.
But now you can look at it.
Yeah, anyone have the same idea? Okay, that's a very good comment. So now can I say how many of you actually really agree on this topic? Should students, university students, should grade their professors?
I agree.
How about Homi? Are you agree? That's a very good point, but now let's have 3 minutes of discussion, and then in this discussion you have like maybe pairs in my group, and later you need to come out your reason and your evidence. So you need to come out with two reasons, and for each reason you need to have evidence, okay? Is that clear?
Yes.
Okay.
Gracias. shows the opportunity to bring the involved in this process.
Do you want more time? Okay. About 1 minute, 2 minutes?
Yeah.
Oh, that's very good. You have more ideas. Now, that's another discussion. And so now we have two different opinions, right? Some of you agree and some of you disagree, right, Tommy? Oh, yeah. The one. Now can I have this group to say your reason why you agree? What you said, because it's kind of like a fact. That's the usual way, right? So can I put it in a way that it's a two-way dialogue between teacher and students? That you are seeing a reason or evidence? Okay,
research.
Research.
The mentor can help improve the teacher's pedagogy. Because I have experience, I was at home with my professor, and she always focuses more on the grammatical mistakes rather than assignments, but after she received especially from international students, she changed the way to grade our assignments. In this way, the teacher better understands the situation of the international students, because English is not our first language.
Yeah, I agree with what you said, because I also have similar experience. Yeah, does anyone have similar experience?
Yes.
Yeah, right? So we can say that it's time for teacher to improve their pedagogy teacher evaluate the way evaluate students. So do you think which type of evidence is the answer? Okay, anyone have different opinion? How about this group? This group has different opinions, right? Can you say more about that? What do you mean they don't have enough agency? Yes. So they cannot actually express all their opinions in general about the performance of teacher, right? There are more things they want to say. Do you have some suggestions? So I can say it's kind of limited, you can put it in a sentence. A limited structure. The structure of feedback form. Do you think it's what type of evidence is? Is there a reason or is that? So now can you provide evidence? So any type of evidence you can. Does anyone have a different opinion? Yes, Chris. So you consider it's actually there is a positive side about this feedback form, even though there is a limited structure, but there is positive side. Yes. So do you have another reason for disagreeing with this topic? I mean, you're the only one who's afraid. Do you have any ideas? Oh yeah, in some degree. Okay, I understand. So in general, about this topic, you actually agree that professor, students should agree that professors. It's just you don't. So you want to make it qualitative? Yes, Andrea? Objective. Yes, so it not, the student might evaluate professor according to their like or dislike, right?
Yeah.
Do you have some kind of evidence? Because our class is about providing evidence. So you are saying that actually there is disadvantage about student evaluate professors. Especially in for the lower grade students, right? They are more emotional than adults. I like our discussion, so we kind of come out with several types of evidence. Yes, Chris? Yes. Yeah, I like what you said because you are really consider the situation in general, like from both sides, right? Anyone have comment on this? It's very hard to make it so perfect, right?
Yeah.
Yes. Nothing is absolute. Yeah, what we can do is just to limit or reduce the bias in this evaluation. I think what I'm seeing, what I hear you're saying is that like maybe they can do some kind of qualitative interview to the students to know more about their opinion of the teacher, right? That's what you're saying? Great. So I really enjoyed our discussion just now. So now, final question, I want to ask you guys to summarize what we have learned today. Can someone help me to do the wrap up? What we have learned today? Anything. You can say whatever you have learned from this class. Yes, Chris? Yes. Yes. So actually what we learned today is not only about this argumentative topic essay, right? We actually can apply this theory into our or not theory, or the way of provide evidence in our real life situation. You know, maybe like what we, at the beginning of class, we have talked about how you convince your mom to buy you a cell phone. So maybe in a day you want to convince your friend to travel with you somewhere, so you can convince them using all those type of evidence. You can say, okay, using authority or using any kind of personal experience, right? You see? Yeah. Okay. Thank you, guys.